All right, what's going on, guys? So today, we're going to be taking a look at the New York Rangers officially signing Brett Berard, prospect from Providence College, and also the Rangers post-game from last night, just giving you guys kind of a game breakdown of what happened. Kind of a frustrating loss by the Rangers. Had it the whole game, but then just lost it at the end. But anyways, taking a look at the New York Rangers officially signing Brett Berard, and now he's a prospect out of Providence College. He's a pretty good one at that. And, Vince Mercogliano, he says, the Rangers just announced that they've agreed to terms with forward prospect Brett Berard on a 3-year entry-level contract that will begin next season. Now, he also, an hour or two after that, signed his, professional tryout kind of contract with the Hartford Wolfpack, basically just meaning, this entry-level contract is not going to kick in until July 1st, so it'll, for next season. So there's 100% chance he cannot play for the Rangers this season, but he's not going to either way. He's going to go play with the Hartford Wolfpack for the rest of this season, kind of like Bobby Trevino did last year. And he'll play with them, finish the season out there. And then more than likely, he'll, go to camp next year and probably go to Hartford, I'd have to guess. I don't think he's going to make it to the Rangers right away. I think he's probably at least another season out of pro hockey, but definitely a guy to look forward to in the future. He's a solid player. He is, Brett Berard, he's a really solid player. Drafted in the fifth round back in 2020, the 134th overall pick. He's a really good player. He's a 5'9", 165-pound guy. Might be a little heavier than that, and a little stronger. I'm sure they've updated that. But, he's a winger, left-handed shot, 20 years old. Born in the States, obviously, Greenwich. But he's a good player. He is. He's a gritty guy. He's a rat, kind of like a – if you look at a Brad Marchand type of player – He kind of has some aspects of that. I'm not saying he has that kind of offense capability because he does not. I don't think he's going to be an NHL superstar kind of like Brad Marchand is. But that kind of play, that gritty, that ratness, that kind of toughness that, even though he's a super small guy with not super small, but 5'9", he's fairly small compared to most NHLers. He plays a lot bigger. He plays with that heart. He plays with that grind, that grit. And he's that kind of guy you want on your third, fourth line going into a playoff series where, you won't need a reliable kind of two-way solid guy who's tough, who's, going to piss the other team off, maybe try and draw some penalties, get in the other team's head, just do all that kind of gritty, dirty work. And he can do that stuff. And he's definitely still a skilled player as well. He's not a bad defensive player. He's not terrible defensively. We'll see if he's ends up being a penalty killer. I have no idea. We'll have to wait and see, but definitely kind of a guy who potentially could be a penalty killer, could be a solid player. I don't think he's going to be second or first line winger. I don't think he's kind of got that kind of skill. But he's definitely a skilled guy, and I think he can be, taking a look at the Rangers, okay? Look at the Rangers' third line, Hedl, Laff, Kako. Those guys could be second liners right now, 100% on most teams. You could fit him on somewhere on the wing, more than likely for most teams. But, for the Rangers, obviously, we're going to the playoff series. We have a great forward core, arguably the best in the league, just on paper at least. Taking a look at that, I mean, obviously you have guys further down the chart. So that's kind of why, if you're a Stanley Cup contending team like the Rangers are, I think Brett Berard is probably a third, fourth liner. But he's definitely a guy who you want in your bottom pairing. And last year had 24 points, 36 games played, had a down year offensively. In 2021, 2022, last season had 36 games played, 38 points. So that was where he had his big year at 18 goals that year as well. And he kind of had a down year this year, but he's looking to hopefully end the season off quite good with Hartford, and hopefully, really impress the coaches and stuff there and have a good camp next year and maybe make the team, who knows, but more than likely be in Hartford. All right, so anyways, guys, moving on here to the Rangers game. This was a tough loss. It really was. This is 100% a game that the Rangers would love to have back. It's annoying. I mean, we had the lead for the whole entire game, scored in the first period. The Canes didn't score in the second or first. The Rangers go into the third period up 1. And then it becomes 1-1. And then the Rangers make it 2-1 quite quickly. And then the Carolina Hurricanes make it 2-2 quite quickly. And then they make it 3-2 not too long after that either. And that was kind of a frustrating way to watch the game end. You watch that entire game with the lead for the majority of the game. The Rangers scored in the first period. It was 1-0 all the way up until the third period. And then the Rangers just let it slip away. I mean, that was a tough loss. It was a bad one. You can't do that, especially when you're taking a look at the standings. I mean, if the Rangers really wanted to make a push for that Metro Division title, I think that's kind of gone now. I think we had to win that game last night, just considering it was a head-to-head against Carolina. Now they're 8 games up with some games in hand, and that's kind of making things a little difficult. But also the Devils now, they lost in overtime last night, so they grabbed 1 point. But same amount of games played as the Devils, both at 71, but they have 6 more points. So it's kind of slipping away there. But with 11 games played left, and I know we have at least one more game against the Devils to play, I think it's still possible. It's just we're going to have to really win some games here, and we're also going to have to hope for some more Devils losses, that's for sure. But it's still a possibility that we could get home ice against more than likely the Devils, but it definitely seems like it's kind of slipping away at this point. But we still have a chance at the Devils. It's just the division title is pretty much gone at this point. 8 points back, 2 games in hand for Carolina. It's pretty much over there. But it was a decent game for the most part. It just, like I said, that third period kind of fell off. Jalen Chatfield, he kind of finished it off with that game winner. Just comes in and just right, he's a right-handed shot, comes down on the right side and just walks in, rip, goal. And that was kind of a tough one, but it is what it is. I mean, the Rangers played solid for the most part of the game, I thought, but just kind of that ending was a tough loss, not the way you wanted to go. But Kako, good for him, he gets a goal. Tyler Mott also gets a goal. Tyler Mott got the first goal, assisted by Jimmy Vesey, and that was really nice. Or Jimmy Vesey and Gaudreau. It was a really, really nice goal. Just great, like kind of slot pass, right to right from Gaudreau to Mottor, and Mottor just buries her, and it was a great little 1-2, very close to the net. But Mottor had a D man right on top of him, and he still made the play, and it was just, oh, that was pretty cool to see. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you guys have, please smash the like button, comment down below your guys' thoughts, and see ya.